Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday Morning and the Old Cookbook Show. Today we're going to do a recipe out of this 1936 book, Magic Chef Cooking, and we're going to make something called sausage loaf. Now, for the eagle-eyed amongst you, you may say, I've seen that book before on your show. Yes, you have. So this is the 1928 version. It's called Lorraine Cooking, and this is the 1936 version called Magic Chef Cooking. And there's quite an evolution between these two books. They're both put out by the same company. They're both put out to sell stoves, both electric stoves and gas stoves, that feature the Lorraine temperature controller. And the earlier book really did push the idea of this temperature controller. By the time you get to the 1936 printing, the temperature controller wasn't as important. They didn't have to explain it. More people knew what it was. It was in more homes. And so when you have a series of cookbooks like this, it's very interesting to see how language changes, how the recipes change, how foods change. And over the course of this 10 years, there really was a lot of change in this cookbook. So for this sausage loaf, I'm going to start out by using our homemade Texas Hot Links sausage meat. And you could definitely use any kind of sausage meat that you want. To that, I'm going to add mashed potatoes, and those are just potatoes that are boiled and then mashed up. A little bit of salt, some pepper, and some breadcrumbs. And next in is some tomato, so it calls for a cup of tomatoes. That's about that much. And so you combine all of these together, and the best way to combine it is with your hands. So, get right in there. And the last thing it says to add is an egg well beaten. So, crack an egg into this little bowl and we'll give it a whisk before adding it to the rest of the mixture. Okay, so I'm going to pop this into a loaf pan. I have the oven preheated to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Because this book is all about the temperature control, you get exact temperatures. And this is sort of the earliest cookbook where these temperatures show up consistently, rather than the old style where they tell you a hot oven or a moderate oven. And with those hot ovens or moderate ovens, there really is a wide range. I know people think that it's a very specific temperature, but when you look across multiple cookbooks, there really is a wide range of what a moderate, a fast, or a hot oven was. So, into the oven, and I'll see you in a little bit.
Hi, Glenn.
Hey, Jules.
Hi, friends.
Sausage loaf. I think we're going to need forks. And I have no clue if I can get this out of the container gracefully.
No, the first piece is never graceful, is it?
Oh, not
That's
great.
That's not too bad.
Not great. Okay, so.
It's got a red tinge to it. What kind of sausage did you use?
I used the homemade Texas Hot Link sausage.
That would make sense.
When I get down to the end of the stuffer and there's not enough to put on a new piece of stuffing, I just put it into containers and use it for stuff like this. So, I'm going to say 95% of all of the flavor comes from whatever sausage you use.
It's definitely the Hot Link sausage.
It's got potato in it, right?
Ah.
So you put in that mashed potato and it makes it a little softer, makes it moister. Even though it looks kind of dry, it's not dry.
No, and with potatoes in it, that means it's pretty much complete. Throw some peas on with it, you're good to go.
I was just about to say, throw some peas on there and you've got a full meal.
I am tempted to put it in a sandwich though, I have to fully admit.
People love that kind of sandwich later.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is kind of an interesting starting point. And it's a different take on a meatloaf in that you're using sausage meat. So you can, you know, your choices are infinite, really. You could do this with chorizo. You do this with breakfast sausage. If you did this with breakfast sausage, let it cool and then sliced it and fried it alongside your eggs.
Yeah, that would be really good.
It'd be like sausage and hash browns in one. I think that.
that would be a winning combo.
Okay. So I think this is another one of those recipes that it's a good starting place to take it other places. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.